The story of crepes. Crepes are usually perceived as thin French pancakes and used to roll certain foods in, but there's much more depth and significance to crepes than it may seem. Crepes are eaten regularly and regarded as ingrained in French culture. The truth is, it unites French people. Its place is to be very variable and an absolute pleasure to eat. It's also to help maintain French tradition that will be there until the end. Yes, be it in the morning, afternoon, or even night. The fillings can differ. For example, a sweet crepe can be for the earlier part of the day, breakfast or brunch, and a savory crepe for the later part of the day, lunch or dinner. However, there is a special occasion for crepes. February 2nd, Day of the Crepe, or also called Jour des Crêpes or Fête de Chandeleur. The holiday is associated with the Catholic feast of Candlemas. Crepes can also be eaten on special personal occasions. Making crepes is relatively simple, but you can put so much inside of crepes. Crepes are divided into two main categories, sweet and savory. French people fill or top crepes with just about anything you can imagine. Yeah, there's a lot. There is a great elaboration behind this rich food. It also gives way to a wide variety of elaborations that allow making the most interesting mixtures, from sweet to salty to savory. A few examples of unique crepe ideas would be beer, cinnamon, chocolate, steak, spinach, mushroom. According to Statista.com, 90% of people like sugar, 86% like jam, 73% solid butter caramel, and 72% Nutella. Following that is 63% in honey, and the rest are below 60%. Guess what? You can eat crepes in any way you want.
Thank you so much.
Merci.
It was in the region of Brittany, France, where the crepes originated, that over the years, their consumption spread throughout the rest of the country, but also towards other countries, being currently very much consumed practically all over the world. The history of crepes dates back to 13th century in Brittany. A housewife there accidentally dribbled some thin porridge onto a hot, flat cooktop. Since people back then weren't inclined to waste even their smallest cooking mistakes, she ate it. The rest, as they say, is history. Of course, this might just be the French equivalent of an urban legend, but it does make for a pretty good story. Here is a map showing the relative amount of crepe sales in France. If you didn't get the hint, it's really popular. But why? Crepes have been eaten by commoners for centuries. Crepes were also commonly eaten religiously and distributedly eaten to honor Jesus. La Fête de la Chandeleur, originally a religious festival, dates back to the Roman times. It falls 40 days after Christmas on February 2nd and marks the end of the festive season.
USA.
US.
Yeah.
You're welcome to Paris.
More importantly, though, its beautiful significance. To be united, no matter the events of the world, arguments, conflicts, to feel that moment of joy together, of the crepe, with its specific filling for you to choose. For all of us to enjoy the food and the endearing taste of your favorite crepe that warms your heart and shows you the true value of life and being united as a people, as a culture. This is why it's significant. This is why it's ingrained in the culture. But also because it's very tasty in all its various ways. I've created a map of how all the ingredients of crepes have gone into France. It talks about the syncretism of Aztecs and European food, the significance of sugar and salt from China, the effective and impactive effect of the Silk Road, important trades, the long-lasting effects of the Roman Empire on food, interesting and impactful trades all across the world, a lot of imperialism and conquests that are a big part of our history and shaped our world, and trust me, much more that I'm sure you would enjoy and learn a lot from. Concepts such as globalization, trade, conquest, interdependence, imperialism, migration, syncretism are all greatly emphasized. Here is a map of the Silk Road, which will help you understand some parts of the interactive map better. You can pause or come back to this whenever you like. The interesting thing about the way most of these ingredients got to France is that they were all through trade, globalization, and cultural diffusion. It was only in 1600 where chefs François-Pierre Lavarenne and Marie-Antoine Carême spearheaded movements that shifted French cooking away from its foreign influences and developed France's own indigenous style. If you are interested in making my family's type of crepes yourself, here are the ingredients. Here's the recipe. It's quite vague because it's not meant to be precise, and you can adjust things in your own way accordingly. Thank you so, so much for watching this far, and I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot. You may now enjoy the crepes. Thank you very much for watching and listening. Je me baladais sur l'avenue, le cœur ouvert. Il est petit et gentil, à stopper au Mexique. Et on s'est poussé à Fugeur et Golo. Il y a tout ce que vous voulez aux Champs-Élysées. Tu m'as dit j'ai rendez-vous dans un sous-sol avec des fous qui vivent la guitare à la main du soir au matin. Alors je t'ai accompagné, on a chanté, on a dansé et l'on n'a même pas pensé à s'embrasser.